July 1970, Electric Lady Studios, Jimmy's pride and joy. This is something that he had built up with his own sweat and blood, with money that he had earned on the road. This was his new home. This is his place where he can go and create and feel free to express himself any way he wanted to. Here comes Dolly. I think Dolly Dagger is a wonderful example of where Jimmy was at that particular time. I mean, you can hear the funk of that guitar. That's going to drive the track, because the original guitar track, which is this, is just a scratch, but now we got the meat.
Electric Lady provided us a place where we could, it was our laboratory. It was a place where we could go in and experiment.
Interestingly enough, what we're doing, he's using his original lead guitar that was cut as the basic track. That's the new, that is the lead guitar. He never replaced that. However, he did add extras. Super clean one, which goes along with.
There was thought of implementing or going in certain other musical directions, which made a lot of sense.
Get along, get along, get along.
And in true 70s fashion.
Heavy mama.
Heavy mama, get it on, get it on.
Get along, get along. Dolly.
But what a great blend of vocals. Jimmy sits perfectly in there. He knows exactly where to put his voice, what pitch, where it should sit with in relation to the Ghetto Fighters. Masterful.
We went in and we were free to create and create to our utmost.
And the great Steve Winwood quote from Billy. So solid, so reliable, just he's Jimmy's anchor. This man is just fantastic.
When Billy came into the band properly, if there's such a thing, as a three-piece unit, it gave me a lot more freedom. And I just started to feel incredibly happy.
I think it's a very cool balance of power between Mitch's newfound funkiness, if you will, integrated with his jazz feel, and Billy's solidness down below, keeping it all tied together. And the fact that they communicated very, very well, the three of them.
She's satisfied till she gets what she's after.
I think Dolly Dagger is a great example of Jimmy's new sound. And I think he was very excited about playing this live.
And some of the new songs, yeah, we just played them, say, the one time, or just had the rough ideas of them in the studio. And it was using the stage to actually build them up and try them. And it felt good for that.